now for today's Bible question. Today we have been learning about the compassion of Jesus and our need to trust in the Lord at all times, obeying His word and not the traditions of men. We learned of a woman of great faith who pleaded for the healing of her daughter, and so someone might ask the question, if I pray to God for healing, will God heal me? If we were to read the story about the woman in Matthew 15, pleading with the Lord to heal her daughter, and saw how her persistence and faith brought about her daughter's healing, then we might be inclined to think that God will heal us if we also show faith and persistence in prayer. However, we need to be careful not to think that God must heal everyone of their affliction when they ask for healing. It is not a matter of how much faith you have or how much prayer you make that determines whether God is going to heal you. We must recognize that sometimes God allows our sickness and suffering for certain reasons, and so it is His will for us to suffer and not to be healed, at least not at this time. It is no reflection upon our faith if God calls us to suffer in a wheelchair or in a hospital bed. Sometimes God uses our affliction to work out His purposes in our life. For instance, concerning the blind man in John chapter 9, Jesus said that his blindness was for the glory of God. He was healed by the Lord, but he also lived many years of his life blind, for it was God's will to demonstrate His power at just the right time in his life. Sometimes sickness is God's will and His means of taking one of His children home to heaven. Sometimes God uses our afflictions to teach us some lesson or to chastise us. Paul was given a thorn in the flesh so that he would not be exalted above measure and become proud because of the great revelations that were given to him. Sometimes our afflictions cause us to be more prayerful, to draw nearer to God, or sense our dependence upon Him more keenly. There are plenty of spiritual reasons why God allows suffering and pain and affliction in our lives. We need to understand this and should be prepared to accept sickness and afflictions as God's tool to work His purposes in our life. I'm not saying that it is pleasant to suffer, for it is not. But suffering is often the road to spiritual maturity and the pathway to a closer fellowship with the Lord. God does heal at times, and we certainly can ask Him to heal us or pray for others to be healed, but we should not expect that God must heal simply because we ask Him to. Man is broken and battered as a result of sin, and God wants us to feel the sting of sin, so that we shall run to Him for help and healing. Sometimes the message does not always reach the mind or the heart when God is speaking through our sufferings, and so He allows us to endure a season of pain until we awaken to our spiritual need. After all, our greatest need is not the healing of our body, but the healing of our soul. There is a sickness that is caused by sin, described in the book of James. And if the sinner confesses and has the elders pray and anoint him with oil, there is a promise that the prayer of faith will heal the sick. We should remember that the sickness here was directly resulting from sin, and through repentance and confession, the person can find forgiveness and healing. So this would not apply to every case of sickness. And he said to me, My grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, most gladly will I boast in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9.